You've seen how to change the color and background color of the text on your page, but there's so much more that you can do with text in CSS. To start off, let's change the font. What's a font? You probably already know what one is, but you may not know the word for it. It's the style of the letters that make up the words, like whether the letters have flourishes on them or how thick they are, or if they look like they're written with an ink pen. Here, it'll be easier if I just go ahead and change the font family on this webpage. I'll go to our PCSS rule that selects all the paragraphs and add a font family property here. Say font family sans-serif. Do you see how the letters changed? Notice they look a bit simpler now. Okay, now let me change the font family back by specifying serif instead. Notice the letters look a bit more complex. A serif font is any font that has what looks like little feet on the letters. When we tell the browser to use a serif font family, it will use the default serif font for the computer, which is usually the Times New Roman font. I'm not a big fan of that font though, so I'm going to change it back again to sans serif. The sans comes from Latin and means without, so a sans serif font is one that doesn't have those little feet on the letters. That's why the letters look simpler. When we tell the browser to use a sans serif font family, it uses the default sans serif for that computer, which is usually Arial or Helvetica. But here's an important point. It'll pick the default font of whatever computer the viewer is on, not the author. So we may very well be seeing two different sans serif fonts right now if your computer has a different default than mine. Sometimes I'm okay with that, but other times I'm picky, and I really want to make sure that whoever's viewing my webpage sees it in exactly the same font as me. In that case, I can specify the precise font name, like Helvetica. This will work as long as both you and me have Helvetica on our computers. But not all computers have the same fonts, and in that case, the computer will just ignore the property entirely. Luckily, CSS lets us specify a fallback font family, a backup, in case a particular font doesn't exist on a computer. We just add a comma after Helvetica, and then bring back sans serif there. Now, the computer will look for Helvetica, and if it can't find it, just use its default sans serif font. Generally, whenever you specify a specific font name, like Helvetica, you should always specify a backup family name as well. Besides serif and sans serif, there are a couple other generic font family names we can use. If we wanted our lyrics to look more handwritten, we could specify font family cursive. Nice. Or if we wanted the lyrics to be a bit fancier, we could try the fantasy font family. Or what if we wanted them to look like they're written on a typewriter? We could specify the monospace font family. A monospace font is fixed width, meaning that all of the letters take up the exact same width. And in fact, you've seen a lot of monospace fonts here on Khan Academy because we always use monospace fonts for code editors. That's because we want all of our code to line up, regardless of the letters in the words. Okay, now that you know how to change the font family, use your power wisely. If you want your page to look good, limit yourself to a few different families and come up with pairs of fonts that look good together. But hey, if you don't want your page to look good, then the world is your ugly oyster. Go forth and fontify.